Hello friends, in the last video, we had seen the first tool of multivariate analysis in Minitab software, that is principal component analysis, with the help of a practical example. In this video, we are going to learn the second tool of multivariate analysis in Minitab software, that is factor analysis, with the help of a practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Factor analysis. The factor analysis is used to assess the structure of your data by evaluating the correlations between variables. Factor analysis summarizes data into a few dimensions by considering a large number of variables into a smaller set of hidden factors that you do not directly measure or observe, but which may be easier to interpret. Using this analysis, you can model each original variable as a linear function of these basic factors. Factor analysis is commonly used in the social sciences, market research, and other industries that uses large data sets. For example, a human resource manager wants to identify the underlying factors that explain the 12 variables that the human resource department measures for each applicant. Human resource employees rate each of the job applicant on various characteristics using a scale of 1 as a low through 10 as a high. The manager collects the ratings for 50 job applicants. Here, the human resource manager performs a factor analysis to summarize data into a few dimensions by considering a large number of variables into a smaller set of hidden factors that you do not directly measure or observe, but which may be easier to interpret. Data considerations for factor analysis. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. You should have at least 2 variables, and the measurements for each variable should be recorded in separate numeric columns. 2. You should have at least 3 variables for each underlying factor. Generally, you should not have more than 1 factor for every 3 variables in your data. For example, if you are having 12 variables, then you should extract at most 4 factors. And 3. Groups of variables should be highly correlated. For the analysis results to be useful, groups of variables should be highly correlated, with small correlations among variables from different groups. Example of factor analysis. Let's continue with the same example. A human resource manager wants to identify the underlying factors that explain the 12 variables that the human resource department measures for each applicant. Human resource employees rate each of the job applicant on various characteristics using a scale of 1 as a low through 10 as a high. The manager collects the ratings for 50 job applicants. Here, the human resource manager performs a factor analysis to summarize this data into a few dimensions by considering a large number of variables into a smaller set of hidden factors that you do not directly measure or observe, but which may be easier to interpret. Conduct a factor analysis in Minitab. To conduct a factor analysis in Minitab, please follow these steps. 1. Enter or copy the data to Minitab worksheet with the data for one variable in one column, as shown in the picture. 2. Select stat, multivariate, and then factor analysis. 3. In variables, enter C1 to C12. 4. In number of factors to extract, enter 4. Here, enter the number of factors to extract from the data. The number of factors to be extracted must be at least 1 and cannot exceed the total number of variables. For best results, you should not have more than 1 factor for every 3 variables in your data. In our example, as we are having 12 variables, we should extract at most 4 factors. If you do not know how many number of factors to extract, then leave the field as blank. 5. Under Method of Extraction, select Maximum Likelihood. Select the correct method to extract the factors. Principal components. Select this option if you do not know the number of factors to extract, or if you cannot assume that the factors and errors obtained after fitting the factor model follows a normal distribution, or you do not have a large number of observations. And maximum likelihood. Select this option if you know the number of factors to extract, or you can assume that the factors and errors obtained after fitting the factor model follows a normal distribution and you have a reasonably large data set. 6. Under type of rotation, select Varimax. Select an option to orthogonally rotate the initial factor loadings. Minitab rotates the axis to give you a different perspective, which can help you to interpret the factors. The original factor loadings are often difficult to interpret. The rotation usually creates a simple factor structure and makes the factors more clearly distinguishable. Rotation also tends to remove general factors that load highly on all the variables. There are below options to select the type of rotation. None, do not rotate the loading. Varimax, maximize the squared factor loadings in each variable. Here, gamma is equal to 1. Varimax is the most widely used rotation method. This rotation simplifies the columns of the factor loading matrix. In each factor, the large loadings are increased and the smaller ones are decreased so that each factor has only a few variables with large loadings. Quartimax maximizes the variance of the squared factor loadings in each variable. Here, gamma is equal to 0. This rotation simplifies the rows of the factor loading matrix. In each variable, the large loadings are increased and the smaller ones are decreased so that each variable will be only load on a few factors. Equimax, rotate the loadings so that the variable load high on one factor but low on the others. This method is a compromise between the Varimax and Quartimax rotations. And Orthomax with gamma. Use loadings based on the value of the gamma that you enter. Enter a gamma value between 0 and 1. 7. In options, keep the default setting as it is. If you are using the data from previous analysis, then make changes in these fields accordingly. Here, we do not using any data from the previous analysis, so keep the default setting as it is. 8. From the graphs, select the graphs you want to see for analysis. All the graphs are same as that of the graphs we had seen in the principal component analysis. And 9. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of analysis in the session window and in graph window. Interpretation of results. Minitab calculates the factor loadings for each variable in the analysis. The loading indicates how much a factor explains each of the variable. Large loadings, either positive or negative, indicates that the factor strongly influences the variable. Small loadings, either positive or negative, indicates that the factor has a weak influence on the variable. Unrotated factor loadings are often difficult to interpret. Factor rotation simplifies the loading structure and makes the factor loadings easier to interpret. Using the rotated factor loadings, the manager concludes the following. Here, company fit 0.778, job fit 0.844 and potential 0.645 have large positive loadings on factor 1. So, this factor describes employee fit and potential for growth in the company. Appearance 0.730, likability 0.615 and self-confidence 0.743 have large positive loadings on factor 2. So, this factor describes personal qualities. Communication 0.802 and organization 0.889 have large positive loadings on factor 3. So, this factor describes work skills. And later, 0.947 and resume 0.789 have large positive loadings on factor 4. So, this factor describes writing skills. Together, all four factors explain 0.754 or 75.4% of the variation in the data. The loading plot visually shows the loading results for the first two factors. This is all about the detailed illustration of factor analysis. We will see the next type of multivariate tools with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.